Hey you guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I will be doing my layering tips video. I'm just gonna go ahead and put this out there. Everyone has their own tips, so these are specifically my tips for any projects that you're working on. It can be from a scrapbook layout to snail mail to project life, pocket letters, all that good stuff. So these are my specific tips and I hope that they help you. They're super simple and we'll go ahead and get started. Hey you guys, so I'm hoping that this is the last time I have to do an intro because I've gotten interrupted multiple times. But today's video is going to be about my layering tips. So I put out a request to see if you guys would like to see that in my last video, and you guys did say yes, so here it is. Obviously each of us have our own layering tips, so these are specifically mine that I want to get out there just to help other people that struggle with it. I have a couple of other tips that I have that I will tell you guys along the way. The first thing I'm going to say is, you know, if you have an idea, like a jotting book or something like that, this one here is from Barnes & Noble. I put down, you know, any ideas that I have for videos or just like crafting related things in here. So I have like little doodles in here. I have like me practicing my calligraphy and you know, just some random like little images. So it really just depends on what you want to use it for. But I even have ideas. So these are for Valentine's Day. I never got these out on video, but I was able to make them. And then this one here is for my layering. And that's just because sometimes, you know, I like to look and see what my mind is thinking when I come to like certain projects. So yeah, so the first thing is, like, you know, if you have a book, I say use it. Kind of write down the tips that you feel like you can use. So if you guys have that, you guys can bust it out and start writing the tips down I'm about to give you. So first thing I'm going to show you are the, you know, main projects that we use to layer on. So one is a 12 by 12 layout. I've created layouts and I've done layering on top of them, of course. So you guys can use a 12 by 12 layout. You can use all these tips on these. You can use it on Project Life layouts or pocket letters. I have some paper bags here from the Target One Spot that you can decorate on top of. And then these tags. Tags are my favorite to work on just because they have different sizes, and my tips go for any size that you're working on. It's not just for pocket letters or any of these, so it's for anything that you're making. Today I'm actually just going to do some paper bags, and that's just because you can pick these up anywhere. And on top of that, I'm really loving these rose gold, and I've never done a embellishing video on bags for packaging, so I thought I'd go ahead and show you guys one on camera. So I did create four other ones, and I'm going to be posting this tomorrow. So if you guys want to see my process video using the tips that I give you today, go ahead and check out tomorrow's video whenever you can. Of course, I will post it on my Instagram when it is posted. So if you guys don't follow me, just follow me on Instagram so you guys know when this video has been released. So these are the four bags. It's a little sneak, but yeah, we'll go ahead and get started here. So now that we have our canvas, we're gonna go ahead and start choosing items to work with. So my first tip to you is to use items that are going to be your largest items on your project. So I did pull out a couple of things here that I can quickly show you. One main thing is scrap paper. We all have scraps. Use them up when you do layering. You can easily create the layered effect just by literally doing this. Right there is already a layer, and that's just by using scraps. You can continue doing this just by putting more and more on top of each other. So I always suggest using scrap paper, and then always use some vellum. It just adds a little bit more texture and another layer without having to overpower the project you're working on. Another is lace. If you have lace like this, this I call a large piece just because I can cut it to any size that I want. doilies are my favorite, so I do use doilies behind my layering, and that's just because it gives it a different look and texture. So I really suggest getting some doilies, different sizes, colors, shapes, whatnot. So there's that. Another one are these paint chips. These are free. I don't suggest going to your Home Depot or Walmart and just grabbing, you know, whatever you want. Just grab what you need anytime you're there, I guess. And that's kind of what I do. So for this video, I did just pick up 5 of these just to show you. Not even sure if I'm going to use them. But there's that. Some tags. If you have any larger tags, you can use this for a background piece as well. And last but not least, journaling cards. So there are some 4x6 that you can use, and some 3x4 cards. I have a couple here from Heidi Swap Picture Skew Collection, and then from the We Are Memory Keepers Type Cast Collection. So you can use that as a large piece as well. Like I said, these are just some examples of large items to use. So that's the first tip that I have for you. It's to use your largest items first. So we'll go ahead and start doing that now. Like I said, I like to use doilies first. So I think that's what I'm going to do. And I think I'm going to go for these pink ones. These are from the Target One Spot from Valentine's Day. So if you guys have these ones, use them. I haven't even used them yet. Okay. Yeah, I like that. And then after I set my doily down, obviously not everyone's going to use a doily. I'll zoom in here to show you. We're not all going to be using doilies. So if you're going to be using patterned paper, it's the exact same concept. But here I'm just going to start layering everything. And what I like to do is I like to have all my supplies near me. And that's just so I know what I have pulled out, what I can work with, and just grab from there instead of having to look around and be like, okay, like what am I going to use? What can I use, you know, right now to layer here? Since I already have stuff pulled out, I know what to look for and just to not go through my stash and use what I have. So that's another tip. Just use what you have on your desk. Don't grab for more. Prepare for your projects. Another tip that I have for you is to not adhere anything down. If you want to adhere stuff down, temporarily use a temporary adhesive. And that's just because you're going to want to start moving things around. And I have that tendency to move things around whenever I have, when I'm doing layering. So I like to just lay things out until I get the exact look that I want here. So I'm actually liking that. So now that I have like my scrap papers, some lace, and a doily, I'm going to start looking through my journaling cards. Out of the larger pieces, this is the last thing I go to because I want it to be right on top. And then from there, if you want to start adding underneath it, you definitely can. Okay, so I'm really liking this Heidi Swap card. And it just says Seek on here, with a picture of a forest. And I'm gonna go ahead and just set that right on top of here, and that's kind of where I want it. So as you guys can see, the layers are starting to happen here. And if you wanna keep adding some more things, you definitely can. I think I am going to use this. Another piece or thing that you can use for layering is crepe paper. I love using crepe paper because it gives it a different look. So as you guys can see, this is why I don't like to adhere anything, because I like to lift stuff up and be able to set it down again. So there's that. If you guys have paper punches, you definitely can use that. I think I'm going to use this little bee one. I did haul this and I haven't shown you guys how it works or looks, so I'm going to do that here. Okay, so this is how it looks. It's spacey in between, but that's when you start layering on top of it, it won't look as bad. So let's see if I can do that. I'm not sure if I want another one. So I think I'm going to go with this. And I'm just gonna mark here, just so I can see where to cut. Okay, so I'm gonna go ahead and see how that looks. So with this punch, you want to offset the fringe. That's just because if they're lined up, it looks like this. And if you offset it, it looks more full. So I'm gonna go ahead and offset it here. And I think I'm gonna curl this over and just adhere it down like that. Okay. So this is how it's starting to look. I'm already having a bunch of layers. When it comes to adhering stuff down, I highly suggest just putting a little bit of adhesive. One, because we're still gonna be tucking things underneath. And two, you never know if you still want to lift stuff up. It's better to have some space to lift it than to have to try to get it right off the edge and end up ripping stuff. And another thing is so that way we can start lifting edges to give it a little bit more dimension. So you can do that. Some adhesive that I like to use is foam dots. I have these foam tabs from Tuesday Morning. I like to use liquid stitch for ribbon because it dries really fast, and it, since it's for fabric, it adheres it really good. Some double-sided tape, just the roll here, and then some roller adhesive. So I'm actually just gonna go for my roller adhesive first. And I always have my glue gun, so that's plugged in. And I'm just gonna open this up. I hope you guys can see this. If I wasn't making a video, I would have all of my pieces that I want to use, like die cuts and whatnot, just spread all over my desk. And that's just because it makes it easier for me to dig through and to see what I have to work with. If you guys are more of a clean crafter, you can definitely do what I'm doing and just go section by section from large, medium, and small. Which is what I'm doing for now. But normally I have everything spread out. I have die cuts on this side. I have my scrap papers here. I have tags on this side. So, you know, it's up to you how you want to set your desk up. So that's how that's gonna go. So I'm just going to put adhesive here. So this one I got from Walmart. I'm just gonna lift this up. And you see how I just put a thin strip right in the center. Another thing that I highly suggest is to not overthink your layers. Because we haven't adhered anything down, just keep going. Don't take anything out. Don't, you know, think, oh, this isn't going to look good, you won't know until you're close to finish. So that's kind of like what I do. As you guys can tell, I haven't taken anything out. I've added things in and it stays there and I've already committed to it. But if you don't like something, when you finally get to the end after putting all your larger pieces down, if you feel like you need to take something down, you definitely can. So don't overthink anything. Just kind of go with the flow. And then if something doesn't work towards the end, you can take it out because you didn't adhere it. And this lace adheres nicely with double-sided, so good with that. And with this, because I'm going to pull my stapler out, I'm just going to staple these edges, and that's just because of the vellum, and to give it a little bit more of a different look. So I'm going to go ahead and adhere this down as well. And I'm just going to adhere the top down. So that way I can start lifting up the fringe part. So it's up to you if you want to lift this up. I'm just going to put it as is. Oh, and I haven't run out. Okay. Alright, so here is how that looks, and that is just using my larger supplies. So I'm just going to adhere the back of this doily. And there is that. So next we're going to move on to our medium things. So for medium, I have some trim, some tickets. These are coat tickets, these are raffle tickets, and these are from pattern paper. The pattern paper ones I've cut and I have a perforator, and I just perforated each little section so I can tear it off whenever I want to. I have this banner that I got from the Target One Spot. Some of these place cards, again, from the Target One Spot. And a bunch of tags because they come in different sizes, so it can go for large, medium, or small. And for die cuts today, I'm going to be using my Maggie Holmes floral die cuts. And so I have some in here, and I'm going to go ahead and dig through there. Like I said, I would probably have these thrown all over my table, just so it's easier for me to choose from, but for video purposes, I'm going to keep clean. And yeah, so let's go ahead and set these aside here. So now we're moving on to our medium pieces. These are our medium-sized elements, so let's see what we can add. There's a lot of pink going on here with this green. It's kind of adding a different color, so I'm thinking of adding the green ticket. I think I'm going to do that, so. Sometimes when I'm confident in something, I'll just adhere it right away. I'm just going to leave it like that for now. I'm going to zoom in a little bit more so you guys can see all these layers happening. So I think I want to try these banner pieces. I'm sorry if you hear the airplanes. I live near a military base, so that's what you're hearing. know that's kind of odd to just place a label on top, but I'm going to use some stickers whenever I know who I'm going to send this to and put their name on there. So that's for that. But we'll see. I might not put this there. I'm not sure yet. So I think I'm good with the layers with, you know, tags and whatnot. So I'm not even going to mess with those. The next thing I'm going to touch is my ribbon and trims to see if I want any. I think I need any. Yeah, for this bag I'm not going to use any, but like I said, I'm going to have a video out tomorrow using the same tips that I just gave you, and I used some ribbon on there. So there's that. I'm going to go through my little box of flowers, see what I can pull out. So this is a large flower. I would use that as a larger piece, so I'm going to try to look for something smaller. I think just that one flower is cute. Okay, so I'm just going with one flower. I probably should add a leaf behind it. So there's that. Now the last thing are your smaller elements. So for these I have just laid out on this tray, and I will zoom out to show you. So I have here some little mulberry flowers, some mini bows, little hearts from the Target One Spot, some wooden clips, and these mini clips from the Target One Spot, thin washi, a little bit of a thicker washi, and some more little flowers. So there's that for small items, and you can also use gems, little enamel dots, little bubbles, you know, whatever you want, but this I like to do as my last thing. Sequins and rhinestones and gems, all of that is my last resort. It's literally the last thing I would do. Sorry for the lighting if that went all crazy. Not sure what happened there. But I'm going to start adhering things down. Again, not fully. I'm just going to put a little bit of adhesive. This one's kind of right, so... I'm really loving these rose gold little banner circles. It just adds like a little bit of a different look. And I just realized when I was making the other bags that it has this rose gold metallic color on the back, because it doesn't show that in the little bag that it's in. If it'll focus. Super pretty. But here's the little glittery one, which we'll be using today. So I'm still not going to adhere that down. A couple other things you can use too are some feathers. I used feathers in my last one. Or like these little mini tags. These are some little tiny, tiny ones. You can use that as well. I'm going to just move on and see what I can add here. Should I add some washi? Yeah, so I'm gonna go ahead and do that. So this already has dimension because it's a little like, banner piece. So I'm just gonna go ahead and I'm actually gonna use my hot glue gun for this one. Not trying to, right once I was saying I wasn't gonna put too much clopped up. So right there. I think it'll be cute up there. So I'm gonna use my hot glue again. My glue gun again. Just kind of place it there. Not sure if I should add. Yeah, I think that's good enough. So if you feel like you need to start adhering things down, as you guys can see, this is like not adhered at all. I'm just gonna grab my adhesive and just start kind of adding little strips, not too much, because we're still gonna want, we still wanna be able to give it dimension by lifting it. So I'm not gonna adhere the whole thing. I'm just taking some of the pieces and kind of like lifting it up. Another item that I really love to use are butterflies, and that's because it has the wings and you can like, you know, flare them open. But this time I'm not using them, and if you guys have seen some of my layouts, I've used butterflies, and that's just because of the dimension it gives. So there is that. So this is how that looks. So you guys can see all the different layers. My technique or my tips are super simple. It's basically what you're working with. It's all the sizes that you want to start with, what you're going to end with. Just like how I haven't put any rhinestones on. But if you'd like, you can, which I'm going to do. But, yeah, so it's really up to you. We all have our own unique style, so no one's is always, like, no one's layering is ever going to look just like someone else's. We all have our own style, and we adhere things differently. It takes practice. I've been scrapbooking and crafting for years already, since I was young. I've been scrapbooking since, I don't know, I was using those scissors. I'm pretty sure a lot of us have. And, you know, throughout that time, I've found how I create. I just found my style. It took me a really long time, so it does take a little bit of time, but you just have to go through trial and error to figure out what it is exactly your style is. There is no rush. Yeah, I know sometimes you will feel like, oh, you know, this is not how Bree's looks like. It's not going to look the exact same as mine. And sometimes I have those times too where I'm like, this just does not look like me. This is not my kind of layering style. You're just going to have to go through that and you'll find your style. It just takes a little bit of time. Some people find it right away and they stick to it for forever, but my style has definitely changed, and if you guys have seen my older videos, you definitely can tell that my style has changed. My scrapbook layouts look different, and that's just because the more I've been crafting, the more tools I've been getting, like a silhouette and all that, so things have been changing. But don't stress the layers. Some people say that they have a hard time, and all you really have to do is just go with the flow and kind of just have fun with it. Don't overthink it, just keep layering. So that is it, and then I will show you guys again the bags I'm going to be using. As you guys can tell, again, I'm using the same techniques with doilies, the lace, having the smaller elements on top. This one I even show you having like a couple of things hanging from the top here, and so that way your recipient can reuse them. So, you know, it's really just up to you. So this is today's bag here, and if you guys would like to see these other ones, just look out for it tomorrow. I hope that this helps you guys and that it wasn't like not helpful at all and it was just a waste of your time, because it is really easy and it's super fun. And yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed, and I'll see you guys, or talk to you guys, in my next video. Bye.